Good morning to 7th standard children. Children, today I'll take a lesson, an English lesson, A Tiger in the House, which is written by Ruskin Bond. Children, have you come across any Ruskin Bond's lesson to you people? I think till now, you have not come across, right? The author Ruskin Bond was born in Kasauli in the year 1934. Children, I'll tell very shortly, very briefly. I'll discuss about this author. And his childhood was spent in the amidst of Himalayas. Because of this, the author likes very much these places. And he has written a few novels. An important novel is Room on the Roof. That too he has written when he was only at the age of 17 years. He wrote that Room on the Roof. And this novel has fetch John Llewellyn Rice Prize, and it is awarded to British Commonwealth writers who are under the age of 30. Right, children? And another English novel he has written, that is Our Trees. And this novel has received the Sahitya Academy Award. It has been confirmed with the Padma Shri, one of the most prestigious awards in India, for his contribution to literature also. And today, this lesson is based on about a relationship between a pet and a grandfather. And even children, are you keeping any pets at your home? Okay, dogs, cats, very good, yes, like that. Okay, first, children, suppose you are keeping any pets at your home, let us think about puppies, okay, puppy, you are keeping for few days, so after 6 to 7 months after that, your granny or your grandfather, they'll tell you, don't want, give this dog to someone else, don't want, some reason will be there. Whether it may be making much noise, or they are not happy with the dog, whatever it is. Okay, right. How do you feel? You feel very sorrowful. Is it not? So you are adjusted with that puppy so well. Fond of that much so much. You are playing with that, is it not? Then one fine day when you are missing that, you are feeling very uncomfortable, right? So such type of thing happens in this lesson. The same, okay, but here it's not a puppy. So what is that? Let us see. Okay, I'll start reading. After 2-3 paragraphs I'll stop it there, then I'll give the explanation of that paragraphs. Okay, shall we proceed now? Right. look at unit 1, a tiger in the house. Author name Ruskin Bond. Look at this picture. A forest guard, he is holding a pair of cheetah cubs in his hands. Poor things, they were abandoned by their mother. Why did she do that? We don't know. But what will this man do with them? He will take them to his officer, who will send them to the veterinarian for a checkup. The doctor will tell them their age and the state of their health. Perhaps he will also tell them whether they are cheetahs or leopards. Do you know leopards? Do you know that in olden days people trained cheetahs to hunt deer? But what will happen to these poor cubs now? What will the forest department do in a case like this? Yes. Can you see this picture, children? A guard is holding a pair of cheetah cubs. What do you mean by cubs? Cubs means here the youngsters of tiger. Okay? So he is holding two cubs in his hands. Poor things, they were abandoned. So abandoned means they were given up by their mother. Means their mother has left them. So why did she must be do that? You don't know the reason, children, here. We don't know. But what this man will do? He will take them to the officer. First, he should take them to the officer. Then, because why he has to take them to the officer? Because he is a forest guard. First, he should bring them to this notice of his officer. Right? So, he will take them to the officer. Then, he will take them to the doctor. Veterinarian, that means one who treats the animals or the pets. He has to take to that him. Then, for a checkup, for health checkup. Then the doctor will tell the age. Understand? He will tell the age and what state of. Understand? He will tell the age and what state of their health. Then perhaps he will also tell them whether they are cheetahs or leopards. Because just cubs will be, they'll be look like as same as the kittens. You have seen the kittens. Kittens means The youngsters of the cat. Just like the cats only they are. It is very difficult for them to find out whether they are cheetahs or the leopards. Cheetahs are different, children, and leopards also different. Are you understand? Yes? Are you understand? Yes? Okay. Cheetahs and leopards. Okay. The difference is cheetah is on the cheetahs, you can see some dots on his on the body. Okay, when it will jump, no, it will take very long distance. Right, and very fastest also. And you know, in the olden days, people they used cheetahs to hunt the deer. Okay, now let us see what this poor cubs will do now. What this forest guard will do. What they will do with that? Are they keeping in their office, children? Are they keeping in their office? No. After that, they will leave them. They will treat them. They will keep them for a few days and check their health condition, everything. After nourishing, after everything, then they will leave it to the jungle. Thing, then they will leave it to the jungle, or else they will give it to the zoo. Understand? Okay. Then, okay, let us see in this chapter. Are there it is? Let us see in the lesson. Right? Shall we start? So before that, take your pencil. Take your pencil, children. In the first paragraph. Yes? First paragraph. Paragraph. Please underline the words and write down the meanings there. The first paragraph, children, fourth line, given up, abandoned, given up. Can veterinarian, a doctor who treats the animals or pets. Okay. We'll move. Okay. From here, just I'll read the lesson. Then and there only, I'll just explain and go. Right, children? First paragraph, children, page number one only. Right? Right? Timothy, the tiger cub. Oh, we have understood. It is a tiger cub. Timothy, the tiger cub, was discovered by grandfather on a hunting expedition in the Terai jungle near Dehra. At first, the tiger cub, who was named Timothy by grandmother, was brought up entirely on milk given to him in a feeding bottle by our cook Mahmood. But the milk proved too rich for him, and he was put on a diet of raw mutton and cod liver oil, to be followed later by a more tempting diet of pigeons and rabbits. I'll explain the same paragraph, children. Here, Timothy. The cub name is Timothy. The tiger cub name is Timothy, was discovered in a hunting expedition. Where he went? To a Terai jungle that is near Dehra. He found the Timothy cub. At the first, the tiger who was named, who named that one? Grandma. The tiger who was named, who named that one? Grandmother named the tiger cub as Timothy. Right? And it was brought up entirely on milk. They didn't fed any mutton or something to that, because it is a cub. Very small one. Right? So because of that, first entirely they have fed that one with milk. How they used to give? In a feeding bottle. Who used to give that one? Their house cook was there. So by name, Mahmood. He used to feed the cub with the feeding bottle. Then, but milk proved too rich. T-O-O-2. Can you make out the difference? That is, means it's very much rich for him. And he was put on a diet. So what diet they used to give? he was put on a diet of, they were not giving the raw mutton or cod liver oil. Then later on, naturally it is a cub children, it is a tiger breed, right? So tempting, what is to eat? Pigeons and the rabbits. So the tempting food for food of, see the second pair of children. Timothy was provided with two companions, Toto the monkey, who was bold enough to pull the young tiger by the tail and then climb up the curtain's tail. And then climb up the curtains if Timothy lost his temper, and a small mongrel puppy found on the road by grandfather. Okay. So, Timothy, even you need friends, no? Yes. Like that, even Timothy had two companions, two friends. So, who are the two friends? One is Toto. What is its name? Oh, sorry, one is monkey. What is its name? Toto. And the other one is? And the other one is a puppy. Yes? So, the Toto was very bold enough to pull the tail. Tail of the tiger. And what it used to do? After it's a monkey, so it used to climb up on the curtains when temper. When it get very angry, it used to climb up the curtains. So another one is a small mongrel puppy. What is mongrel puppy, children? Mongrel means a mixed breed. So it right on the road, found on the road. So that even another friend of, it is another friend of this Timothy. Right? Shall we move to the third paragraph? At first, Timothy appeared to be quite afraid of the puppy and darted back with a spring if it came too near. He found Meg absurd dashes as it with his large forepaws and then retreat to a ridiculously safe distance. Finally, on his back and rest there. Yes, when you bring a puppy to your home, in the beginning it looks like little bit as though it got very afraid of you people. Right? Even this Timothy, it used to appear afraid of the puppy. That mongrel puppy was there now at home. So it used to feel like getting very scared of the puppy. And darted back with the spring if it come too near. If it come near, it is to get a little bit back. It is to go back. And then what it started to do? He would make absurd dashes at it with his large forepaws. And then retreat it to a ridiculously safe distance. Then both were adjusted. Both were little adjusted. Then what is it used to do? So it used to unreasonably used to dash the puppy with his forepaws. Forepaws means the front two paws, legs, that is we'll call the forepaws. So it used to unreasonably it used to dash with the forepaws and it used to making something silly, a joke like a joke ridiculously. Then finally what it used to do, it used to make that puppy to crawl on his back and rest there, just to crawl there and stay wherever it is, not to come very near to the right. Yes, children, paragraph 4, page number 2. Shall I continue? Yes. One of Timothy's favorite amusements was to stalk anyone, and so when I came to live with grandfather, I became one of the tiger's favorites. With a crafty look in his glittering eyes and his body crouching, he would creep in closer to me. Suddenly, making a dash for my feet, rolling over on his back and kicking with delight and pretending to bite my ankles. Yes. One of Timothy's favorite amusement. What is amusement? Time passing games here. Okay, time passing. So one of its favorite amusement was to stalk anyone who would. To stalk means here to strike very stiffly. To be very stiffly. Used to play with them. And so when I came, I here refers to the author when you at his childhood. Do you understood children? I refers to the author. Right? When the author came to live with his grandfather, he was very favorite for the tiger. He became very favorite to the tiger. Which tiger? Timothy. With a crafty look in his glittering eyes. The eyes will be very glittering. Timothy's eyes was very glittering, shining. And his body crouching closer. So, you might have seen that one. Usually the puppies, they will keep the two legs front and just they will be crawling. In the beginning they will crawl and then they will come to the place. Before they used to come to us with as though they are playing. Like the two legs front legs, and then they will start coming to very closer, right? So even this Timothy used to crawl and slowly it used to creep and coming very close to the author. Suddenly making dash to the feet, just moving, giving a dash to the feet. Then there will be roll in front of, it used to roll in front of him. And again, kicking with delight and pretending as to bite my ankles. So as though we are playing with the puppies, the same games we can observe here. Okay, so when you are moving, when the author was moving, just it used to pretend as though it to bite his ankle. So it is just playing with the author. Right, children? Then, so here the family members are taking much care to this Timothy and naturally grow, right? Shall we go for the fifth paragraph, children? Okay. He was by this time the size of a full grown retriever. And when I took him out for walk, people on the road would give us a wide berth. When he pulled hard on his chain, I had difficulty in keeping up with him. His favorite place in the house was the drawing room. And long sofa, reclining there with great dignity and snarling at anybody who tried to get him off. Yes. Here he refers to the tiger Timothy. So after a few days this is. So after that, as time passes, it has grown. Grown, a full grown retriever. So retriever means a dog which is trained. That is middle sized hunting dog we'll call it as. That is middle sized hunting dog we'll call it as. Right. So it has grown little bit. And when I here refers to the author. When the boy, here the author is a boy. Okay. When he take him out to walk, people on the road walk, people on the road, what will be their condition? So they used to maintain a distance. They used to maintaining a safe distance. They never used to come near. Okay. Then sometimes it will pull very hardly. So when it will pull the chain very hardly, it was very difficult for the author to keep him up. And what is Timothy's favorite place in the house? Drawing room. That usually be a hall. Okay. So a drawing room. And he would make himself very comfortable. So he used to be very comfortable. That is things to make life very easy. Comfortable. Very comfortably on the long sofa. So it used to recline. Recline means actually recline we call it for a chair. Recline for a chair. Taking rest. Easy chair. Okay. So it used to sit on the sofa very comfortably. It used to sit on the great dignity. Somewhat prestigiously it used to sit on the sofa and snarling. If anybody comes to, anybody try to get rid of him from that place, it used to snarl him. What do you mean by snarl? Making sound. Growl. Grrr. It used to growl to them.